theater started in caves in the far, 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 far distant, almost prehistoric past. And it answers a very basic need, which is to have stories played out for you. There's nothing more compelling or attractive, but it's always stories we're telling. And there's never going to be a time when people don't want to hear stories from people the whites of whose eyes they can actually see. That they want to feel that they're in the presence of somebody who is actually talking very directly to them. And I sort of repeat myself a little bit, but you forget that the thing about television and TV is that you can't change anything in the actors' performances at all. That's it. They're fixed for all time. They may be, you know, wonderful performances. They may have every appearance of spontaneity, but they're never going to change. It happened. It's historic. What happens in the theatre is present. It's now. It's something that proves to ourselves that we're alive, you know. We're engaged and connected and can interchange with each other. That's the glory of the theatre. That's what it's all about.